point is, we weren't as talented as a lot of teams that beat us, but because there was a vision. And so many people bought into the vision that people performed above their capabilities because they were focused on the vision. My question is, God is your head coach, and what vision has He given you? Because it's so easy to say, man, God wants me to do this, but I don't have the ability. Here's what I'm saying. When we focus on the vision, oftentimes we perform above our ability because where the focus goes, the power. What ability do you have? God didn't ask you, what do you have? He never asked you, what don't you have? God is not looking at your ability. He's looking at your availability. Not about ability, not about inability, all about availability. Are you available to fulfill that plan? Are you available to operate God's vision for your life? And when you begin to operate the vision, what you do, you'll find yourself in the right spots. And when you find yourself in the right places, then the right things happen. Some might say, I can't fulfill God's vision, I'll never do it. If you just keep doing the little things, if you keep focusing on those minor details that God gives you to clean up and straighten out, you'll be amazed how doors just open up for you. If you just begin to operate in the gifts that lead to the fulfillment of your vision, my Bible says that your gifts will focus you on joy. Have you ever played a whole football season and been healthy the whole season? You've been helping. I've never seen. Have you ever played a game? You were like, man, I'm really hurting, but you just suck it up and play it away. At the end of the game, if you win, does it matter that you were hurt? Here's what I'm saying. That there's sometimes you have to get in the game and you might not be 100%. You might be feeling a little down. You might be feeling depressed. But just because you're down and depressed, that's not a reason to sit on the sideline. Just because you have a reason to sit on the sideline doesn't give you the right to sit on the sideline. Just because somebody hurt your feelings doesn't give you the right to harbor hatred in your heart. Just because I feel like going off, just because I have a reason to go off, doesn't give me the right to go off. I'm going to keep the vision because at the end of the day, you'll be happy because you'll find out that you're the vision of God coming to pass is found in those daily disciplines. Again, Bishop has taught us that word, that suffix, ETH. When you add ETH on the end of the word, it means continually. So as we continue to keep the law, what happens, it'll make us happy. It might not be happy while we're going through it.
Come on.
But when you get to the end, you'll be real happy.
I've been
through a lot of practices that were horrible. I've been through practices that were freezing outside. I mean, it is so cold, you can't feel your hands. I've been in practices that it was raining. Horrible conditions, hated it. Been through practices where it's so hot, you can hardly drink the water because the water bottle is so hot. And when you drink the water, it feels like hot coffee you drink. Just horrible. But if you keep the faith, if you keep on doing it, and you get to the end and you win, you realize it was all worth what I'm going through.
Yeah.
Here's me to tell you, what you are going to is well worth what you're going to do. To keep God's law, your head coaches continue to give you directions through the quarterback. Continue to keep that law, keep those directions. Focus on the vision, because when you're not focused on your vision, that's when it's so easy to say, man, forget that. I forget it. It's just not worth it. No, it's very worth it. It's very worth it. And when you get to the end, again, what you attain at the end is going to be, it's almost like a woman having a baby. Those 9 months are rough. You know, some women, you get off work. I'm not going to say which women. But some women, you get off work and you ask them, do you want anything, because they had a long day at work? And they say, no, they don't want anything. So you take a shower and you get ready to go to bed. And this particular woman said, can you now go to Sonic and get me some crushed ice?
Be careful, be careful.
Uh-oh.
He said, do you want a lemon berry slush? Do you want to die like a pebble? I just want to crush ice. And you think to yourself, didn't I ask you 2 hours ago before I took a shower? Did you want anything? And so you go to Sonic and you say, can I just get some crushed ice? And they say, do you want a Route 44? Do you want what? I got a pregnant wife at home. I just want some. Okay, I got you, sir. My point is, what we went through wasn't fun. But the end product was well worth it. So I want to encourage you to keep listening to the head coach. Keep the law. And at the end, you'll be very happy.